Hi everybody, welcome once again to our Low on Health Daily Rambling, me just kind of going over what I've been doing the last past day or so. Got a lot of kind of video type of things I want to get to real quick, so let's just go ahead and get through these. Up on the Escapist, we have of course the Unskippable and the other Loading Ready Run skit. And as always, I really enjoy the Loading Ready Run people, and I just want to mention, of course, watch these two things. They are definitely funny. Reduce Your Footprint is extremely funny. But I always just want to mention how much I enjoy the Loading Ready Run crew and their talent and their actors and everything. Also moving on here, Oscars were the night before. Just want to go over the winners real quick. As you probably all know now, you know, Hurt Locker won for Best Picture, in which case, you know, I enjoyed Hurt Locker and happy to see that Avatar didn't win. Hurt Locker also got Best Director. Jeff Bridges got a Best Actor for Crazy Heart, which I never saw. Almost wish, you know, George Clooney would have got it for Up in the Air, because I really enjoyed Up in the Air. Sandra Bullock got it for The Blind Side, which I've never seen. Best Supporting Actress was Christopher Waltz for Inglourious Basterds, which a lot of people were rooting for, and I actually enjoyed his role, and I'm happy to see that he got that. Best Supporting Actress, don't really care. Screenplay, Hurt Locker, which is kind of cool. Adaptation, don't care. Best Animated Film went to Up, which I'm very happy to see Up got it, because I really enjoyed that movie, and you should definitely watch Up. Avatar at least got art direction, whoop-de-doo. Cinematographer, also Avatar, whoop-de-freaking-doo. And some other stuff that I never really heard of or care about. Hurt Locker also got film editing. Hurt Locker got a lot of stuff. Makeup, Star Trek, that's kind of cool. Up for original score. Original song went to something else, and then a bunch of other crap. Hurt Locker also got sound mixing and sound editing. Wow, Hurt Locker just kind of ran the freaking Avatar visual effects. There you go, Avatar got something. Would have given that to District 9, though, because I definitely enjoyed District 9 more for visual effects-wise. Of course, I've never seen Avatar. Don't plan to for a while. Moving on here. I did watch, movie-wise, The Men Who Stare at Goats. As I mentioned before, I watched Up in the Air, and I was like, oh, maybe I should watch other kind of mainstream-ish type movies, and this is another George Clooney film. In which case, I watched this movie and realized that it wasn't worth my time. Didn't really enjoy it that much. Kind of hoping it's not just to be more kooky, but more smart. In which case, it's just kind of a dumb film. It has great actors in it, though. I really like all the performances are good, but the actual subject matter and just the plot itself is just kind of crap in my mind. So if you have a chance to watch The Men Who Stare at Goats, you might want to watch something else. Moving on here, the new Iron Man 2 trailer, speaking of movies, basically was released, in which case this trailer looks amazing. And as always, Iron Man kind of surprised a lot of us by showing it's, you know, a comic book movie that was done really, really well. And this second movie, a lot of people have been highly anticipating, and it's probably one of the movies this year I'm very tempted to go see in the movie theater, because I really enjoyed the first one, and this one just looks like it's going to be amazing. So hopefully, you know, this trailer kind of sets it all up. Try to remember when it was supposed to come out. Let me see if I can scroll down the information here. Supposed to be out March 7th. Oh, the trailer was released March 7th. Don't know when the movie's actually supposed to come out. I'll probably do some research on that later. But this trailer looks amazing. Definitely watch it in high def if you get a chance. It's just phenomenal. And a lot of people are looking forward to it. You know, it's just nice to see, like, Batman and Iron Man kind of doing service to comic book movies as opposed to the old horrible Batman movies back in the day. Moving on here, Gamefly. They did ship me Final Fantasy 13. So hopefully I will be playing that tomorrow or the day after. I'm kind of gearing myself up for, not getting myself hyped up for, I don't expect much out of it, but I'm kind of planning my day around it. I'll probably maybe go out, get some pizza, and just kind of plow through it. Debating if I'm going to do like a whole playthrough Final Fantasy 13 without sleeping, kind of doing one sitting, just kind of an endurance thing to test myself out, test my merit. So that'd be kind of cool. They haven't moved Yakuza 3 up yet, which is kind of disconcerting. Hopefully they'll move that up to tomorrow, Tuesday. In which case, I might have to send back, you know, hopefully I'll beat 13 quick enough and send it back so I can get God of War 3. But we'll see what happens then. I might have to take God of War 3 out of my queue. But other than that, I've kind of just been playing, you know, Modern Warfare 2, of course, here and there. Almost getting ready to prestige again and just kind of relaxing. Didn't really get that much done today. Wanted to write some more reviews, but just not in the mood. But other than that, as always, I'd like to thank you guys for watching, and I'll catch you next time.